This video on Google Fonts. Using a font host is a great way to add some new fonts to your content without having to worry about downloading and uploading that file to your file server. Here we're using Google Fonts. You may navigate there at fonts.google.com. Here you can search for the font you're looking for if you already know what it is, but like most of us, you probably just want to look through fonts for a little. Here you can change the sentence you're looking for to a custom sentence or content. I'm going to go ahead and type in Disco Stew. I'm looking for some specific font to represent my content for Disco Stew. I can change my font size here if I was looking to see what it might look like in a sentence case or as a headline. Now I'm going to want this pretty big, so I'm going to make that 100 pixels. The next thing I might want to do is to narrow down the categories, the types of fonts that I'm looking for. If I know already that I'm going to use something that is a little bit more decorative, I can go ahead and uncheck all of these standard generic font families and use just display. Sometimes you heard these called decorative or display fonts, which means they're going to be used sort of minimally in headings and headlines for a little bit extra interest. As I was checking those boxes on and off, you could see in the background that the fonts that are being displayed start to shuffle. Based on the choices that I'm making. So I can change those here. I can reset it as well. Often you'll be looking for a specific language within your font. So if you know that you're going to be writing content in another language, you can actually choose that here. It's important because not all fonts are available in all the characters that all languages have. And lastly, I can change the font properties, the number of styles that a font has. And that means if it has a regular, bold, italic, that sort of thing. If you're looking for something that has a lot of styles, you might play with that slider. You might also just know that you're looking for a nice, thick style font. And so you can change the thickness here. If you wanted a really thick lettering, you could change that. And I'm going to go ahead and change that a little bit. I do know that I want a nice thick typeface. You can also change the slant or the width, or again, you can reset this. Now, in the background, you've seen those fonts shuffling around, changing and displaying my content, my custom content in that typeface. So now I can kind of scroll through and look for the perfect font to represent my content. And as I'm strolling through, yeah, no, that seems very cowboy, not at all Disco Stew. This, very much so, I like that bungee shade, nice. And taking a look at some of these, scrolling through, as a designer, you spend probably hours scrolling through the fonts that you're looking for. And I have one in mind and I'm not seeing it here. So maybe I set the thickness a little bit too much, but I know that I'm searching for a font called Monotone. And I typed two O's in there. So let's try that again. And I'll go ahead and reset my thickness. And there it is. Looks like I had it set a little bit too thick. So again, you can search through names, or you can search through attributes of that font. And this is the one that I was looking for. And I'll go ahead and click on that. When I click here, I can see the name of the font, who it was designed by, the different styles that are available. In this case, there's only one style available. It's only available in the font weight of regular, which is about 400 in terms of its keyword and value. The glyphs that are available are listed here. So this is not too heavy on the glyphs. If I was looking to add a lot of content with an ampersand, I'd want to look here to make sure that they have that glyph and that I like it. And I think that's what this is supposed to be. And actually not my favorite ampersand there, but I want to make sure that all of the glyphs that I might use with this font are available. And you can see this only has uppercase letters and a couple of different glyphs, so it wouldn't be appropriate for all projects. As I scroll down, there's a little description about the font itself and the designer. And the license, the fact that this is an open font license is what lets us use this and connect to it. If I keep scrolling, you can see some popular pairings, font pairings for this particular font. This pairs very well with Roboto. And so that might be my cue to download both of these files. It might pair well with Montserrat or Open Sans. And so I can take a look at any other fonts that I might want there to download with. But I like this one. I'm going to go ahead and look at it. And I want to select this style. So I'll go ahead and select it. If you've noticed, I can say remove selection if I already have it. And now what I want to do is take a look at that. So I'm looking at all of the selections that I've made. So I could make a lot of selections and then go through and try to narrow down which one I want. But here is where I will click to see the selected font families that I have. Here's Monotone, and it's in regular 400. And now here is all of the CSS and HTML that I need to copy it into my document. So I'm going to switch over to CodePen. And you can see there's my content, Disco Stew, written in an H1. And in the default browser style, that turns up like this. It's a serif font, it's bold, it's a little bigger than normal, but it absolutely does not have the personality of Disco Stew. So let's go ahead and give it that. Switching back to Google Fonts, I can choose either link or import. I'll show you both. Link is going to give you a link tag that you need to copy and paste into the head tag of your HTML document. Now we're in Google CodePen, so I can just post it here at the top, and that links that font at Google Fonts to my document. And now I step two is that I want to apply that to my content. So I'm going to go over to my CSS where I'm going to write a declaration. And so I want to start with my selector, which is H1, a simple element selector. And then I know I want to change the font family, and Google Fonts actually gives that to me as well. So the CSS rules to specify this family is font family monotone, and then it has a font stack that ends with cursive. So we'll go ahead and copy that. Switch back to Google Fonts, and we'll paste that in for our font family. And if you just noticed, it changed to monotone, Disco Stew. Now, this looks pretty good, but there's some intricacies and some fine lines that we're losing because it's not very big. So we'll go ahead to the CSS and we'll add a font size that's a little bit bigger, and we'll go ahead and call it 100 pixels. And now, of course, Disco Stew blows up big, and you can see more of those fine lines. Still losing some in the T, so I know I have to know that for this font, I'm going to have to make it really big in order to see all of those delicate lines. And of course, make sure that that's appropriate for the content that I have. All right, so that's how we link a Google font using the link tag. Again, link would go into your head tag of your HTML document. Let's go ahead and take a look at it another way. So we'll go ahead and delete that. And you'll notice Disco Stew goes away and goes to our backup font, which is cursive. And this is the backup font that my system chose for cursive. Not exactly what we were looking for. We'll go back to Google Fonts and we'll go ahead and change this from link to import. Now, import works very much so like at font family. And so here they've given us the code to embed that style. Again, this embedded style would go in the head of our HTML document. So we'll copy that, go into Google Fonts, and paste that into our HTML. And you'll see there it goes. Disco Stew is now being connected. Step one is to connect to that font. And then step two is to declare that font. Now we can also use at import in the CSS. So we'll go ahead and cut it from there, remove the style, and I'll add it into the CSS and paste it in. And now that at import rule is happening entirely in the CSS, grabbing onto that font hosted on Google Fonts. And then after we have referenced it, we can declare it. And that is how you use a font host, specifically Google Fonts.